Good evening, and welcome to your annual membership meeting. We appreciate you being here tonight. At Central Texas Electric Co-op, we provide our membership with safe, reliable, and affordable electricity. I'm happy to tell you that our co-op is in very good condition and has an optimistic outlook for the future. This evening, we will bring you up to date on activities that have taken place since we met last year. We will present the financial report and show you some of the folks who make our cooperative a great organization.
As chairman of the Finance Committee, I will now give you a brief summary of the financial condition of our co-op for the year 2013. Our co-op continues to be financially strong. Last year, we experienced a year of positive, manageable growth. We added 653 new meters, which means there are now a total of 37,431 meters connected to the system. Also last year, 37 miles of new electric lines were added to the system, which now totals 6,245 miles of overhead and underground distribution lines, and over 69 miles of transmission lines. During 2013, the utility plant in service increased in value by $6.7 million and now totals $192 million. Operating revenues decreased in 2013 and ended the year at $51.7 million, down about $1.8 million from 2012. This lower figure was due primarily to lower member power costs related to weather conditions. Total operating expenses also decreased in 2013 to $43.6 million at year end, which was down $3.2 million from 2012. This lower figure was due mainly to a decrease in purchase power cost and lower distribution and operating cost. Bottom line, our 2013 net margins were $5.4 million. Of this amount, $905,000 was paid back to members in capital credits. Total assets of the cooperative increased to $163.5 million, up over $10.4 million from the year before. This increase was due mainly to construction of new lines and system improvements. It is the goal of the board and management to keep our system in top condition so that we can provide our members the most reliable service possible. At year end, the equity ratio for the cooperative was over 38%, which is a very healthy figure. The complete year-end financials for Central Texas Electric Cooperative can be found in the annual report that was included in your August issue of Texas Co-op Power Magazine. You were also given a copy of this financial report when you registered this evening. Thanks for your continued interest in the financial health of your cooperative.
Operating Central Texas Electric Cooperative is a capital-intensive effort. Those fancy words mean that our business is expensive to build and maintain. Substations, transformers, and thousands of miles of electric lines that cross some of the roughest terrain in the state cost a lot of money to put in place. On top of that, because our investments are exposed to the sometime wild and destructive weather patterns of Central Texas, maintenance and repairs are ongoing efforts. CTEC has more than 120,000 poles in our system. Last year, as part of our ongoing maintenance, we inspected almost 7,000 poles, and of those, over 1,500 were replaced. In addition, construction was completed to re-energize the Nebo substation north of Fredericksburg, which serves the Eckerd area along Highway 16. This upgrade will improve service and allow for additional growth. Other significant projects for the year were the completion of a voltage conversion in the Eckerd area, the completion of a second main circuit in the Ingram-Goat Creek area, completion of rebuilding the lines west of Cherokee, the completion of two reconductor projects in the Castell area, and continued work to rebuild and improve the lines serving the Harper area. Our crews and contractors remain busy across our entire 11-county service area. Last year, our crews rebuilt 47 miles of existing lines with new conductors and, where needed, new poles. We also spent more than $1.3 million to re-clear right-of-ways throughout the system. We do all this maintenance and improvement to make sure our system is in tip-top shape. All of these efforts improve safe working conditions for our linemen and help provide reliable power to you, our member owners.
When I started working here 30 years ago, Power supply cost was the largest expense that the co-op had. Today it remains the same, with more than 60 cents out of every dollar that you send to us going to pay for the power that we purchase from generators. Perhaps the biggest news regarding power supply that has happened since our annual meeting last year is we settled our long-running dispute with the Lower Colorado River Authority in April. Yes, we have divorced ourselves from the LCRA Generation Corporation, but we still have a strong and beneficial working relationship with the LCRA Transmission Services Corporation. They will continue providing us assistance with transmission, substation, and radio communication. Regarding generation, the obvious question is, how did we come out of the deal? Well, let me tell you. If you are a residential member using 1,000 kilowatt hours a month, last month your bill would have been $103.50. In May of last year, your bill would have been $110.50. That means you're paying $7 or roughly 7% less this year than you did last year. A look back over the last 5 years shows that prices held fairly steady through 2013. But obviously, changing power suppliers has played a major role in the reduction of your monthly electric bill. When comparing average residential monthly electric bills to other area co-ops, CTEC does quite well. As you can see, we are the low-cost provider of the group, and that's in spite of the fact that we have the least number of meters per mile of line. Taking a comparative look at the prices last year and the prices this year, CTEC is the only co-op whose bill has gone down. This is a bit of a surprise to me, and I can't really speak of what has happened at the other cooperatives. But for a long time, we've had an all-out effort to reduce the cost of electricity to our members. To me, it's obvious that our efforts have paid off. This is an accomplishment that everyone associated with your cooperative is very proud of. Your board, your management, and your employees.
When people think about Central Texas Electric, they normally think poles, wires, transformers, and other electric equipment. But that is not the only purpose your co-op serves. We really are about people. A good example of this is the support we give the youth in our area. The Central Texas Electric Scholarship Program, which is now in its 17th year, awarded 40 co-op students with $1,000 scholarships in 2013. To date, your co-op has awarded 459 scholarships to local students. The $459,000 used to fund these scholarships does not come from your electric bills, but rather from unclaimed capital credit funds. Since 1965, your co-op has been sending high school students to Washington, D.C. on the Government in Action Youth Tour. On this adventure, they gain leadership skills, visit national landmarks and museums, and meet with their elected officials. The Operation Roundup program allows Central Texas Electric Co-op members to voluntarily round up their monthly electric bills to the next whole dollar amount. The average contribution is only 50 cents per month, but this small monthly donation has allowed the program to approve 86 grants, totaling over $100,000 since its inception. These grants have helped local people and organizations in our communities. If you are not already rounding up your bill, just call any of our offices to sign up. We call it Neighbors Helping Neighbors. We're also excited about our Smart Hub app that was introduced in May of this year. It helps you manage your account on the go, giving you the ability to check daily, weekly, or monthly usage. One great feature is the ability to compare your daily electric usage to the weather conditions experienced on that day. With Smart Hub, you can pay your electric bill, set up recurring payments, set power usage alerts, or view your payment history. The Smart Hub is a free app and can be downloaded to your smartphone, tablet, or desktop computer.
As you can see by this report, your co-op is busy making a difference in the lives of people we serve. Your board of directors is constantly looking out for you, our members. And one of our responsibilities is to anticipate future changes. Since our business model has basically changed after our separation with LCRA, and distributed generation is becoming more popular, we need to examine how these changes will affect the co-op and our members. Later this year, your board will do just exactly that by holding a series of workshops to examine the various aspects of the business and make sure that our members are getting the best value for their dollar. Tonight, we have reported on our finances, operations, power supply, and involvement in the community. And that leads me to one final point. This year, I'm finishing up my 11th year on the board, and I've witnessed the dedication, helpful attitude, and expertise of our employees, whether they are in the office or the field. Here at CTEC, we have some of the best that there are. They are the heart, the soul, and the spirit that makes your cooperative work. They also just happen to be your friends, family, and neighbors.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life. And I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today. 'Cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, there ain't no doubt.